several days now that there are alternative options. The White House has been
contemplating. Hang on, Abby. Here's the president.
We're doing a great job at the border considering we don't have the tools. That'll give us the tools to work with Nini. We have to have a wall. We have to have a barricade of some kind, a steel barricade. It's already designed. We're building a lot of wall as we speak, a tremendous amount, and we're renovating a lot of the other wall. Otherwise, by the way, with what's coming up, because of the strong economy that we have, we haven't had an economy like this, I guess, in over 50 years. Would you say that's correct, Steve?
Yes, sir.
And because of the strong economy, everyone's pouring up, and we're stopping them. But it's a lot of work. We have incredible people at the border, and you have to thank all of the Border Patrol agents and the ICE agents. I see in Long Island, they don't want ICE. The radical Democrats don't want ICE there because they're too good. They're doing too good a job. And I always talk about Long Island. That's one of the real hotbeds for the MS-13 gangs. And I just see this morning where the really radical Democrats don't want them there because they don't want to do anything to disturb MS-13. And when you think about it, MS-13 is about the most violent gang. They say one of the most violent anywhere in the world. And they have done, we're sending them out by the thousands out of our country. So we think it's too bad. But I would say this, that the State of the Union speech has been canceled by Nancy Pelosi because she doesn't want to hear the truth. She doesn't want the American public to hear what's going on. And she's afraid of the truth. And the super left Democrats, the radical Democrats, what's going on in that party is shocking. I know many people that were Democrats and they're switching over right now, and they're switching over quickly. So I hope they know what they're doing for their party. So far, they haven't. If you know, I won the Senate, meaning we won the Senate all together, but we get no credit for that. They don't talk about that. They talk about the House. I didn't have any chance to, other than a couple of people, like from Kentucky, where I went and campaigned for Andy Barr. And for some others, they ended up winning their races, but I couldn't campaign too much, too many people. But we did a great job with the Senate, and people don't want to talk about it. I will say that the American people want to hear the truth. They have to hear the truth. And the truth is all about and said, I think, and I hope, well, we were planning on doing a really very important speech in front of the House and the Senate, the Supreme Court, and everybody else that's there. It's called the State of the Union. It's in the Constitution. We're supposed to be doing it, and now Nancy Pelosi, or Nancy as I call her, she doesn't want to hear the truth, and she doesn't want to hear, more importantly, the American people hear the truth. So we just found out that she's canceled it, and I think that's a great blotch on the incredible country that we all love. It's a great, great, horrible mark. I don't believe it's ever happened before. And it's always good to be part of history, but this is a very negative part of history. This is where people are afraid to open up and say what's going on. So it's a very, very negative part of history. I'd like to start today. We're talking about shutdown. We're talking about some conservative values. These are the great conservative leaders of our country.
Okay, so that was the president there commenting again on what he is referring to as the radical Democrats and how he's characterizing how Speaker Pelosi canceled his State of the Union.